The answer is the first choice. And we know this is the case because this set has n minus 1 elements. We also know that there are no duplicates in this set because we know that n is prime and a is not divisible by n. So that means this will generate the numbers 1 through n minus 1 in some order, some permutation of those. But since it's a set, it's the same as the set 1 through n minus 1. This turns out to be a useful property for proving Fermat's little theorem because we can set these two things as equal and multiply all the elements in those sets. So since we know they're the same set, we know that their products are also equal. And this product is n minus 1 factorial. So since the sets contain the same elements, we know their products also must be equal. So this is the product of the first set. This is the product of the second set. It's n minus 1 factorial because it's multiplying all those numbers up to n minus 1. N mod n, those must be equal. We took the mod n out of each of these terms, but that's fine. Then we can simplify this, taking out the a's. And so if we take out all the a's, what we have is 1 times 2 times 3 dot 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 times n minus 1 times a, still equal to n minus 1 factorial mod n. So now we can separate this, taking out all the numbers and all the a's. So we'll have n minus 1 terms. So we have a to the n minus 1 here, times all the numbers is still equal to n minus 1 factorial. This is the same as n minus 1 factorial. So now we can remove these terms, and we're left with exactly what we wanted, that a to the n minus 1 is congruent to 1 mod n. So this is pretty close to what we want, but what we needed for Euler's theorem, and what we'll need for the RSA correctness proof, is this property with the totient of n, and that's different from what we have here.